Hello everyone, welcome to the algorithm course. Now I'm going to walk through the selection sort with you. It involves mainly four steps. First, we find the smallest element in the unsorted list, which is part of the given list of numbers to be sorted. Second, if we see that the first element in the unsorted list is not equal to the smallest element in the unsorted list, I will do the swapping between the two numbers. And then I will lengthen the sorted list and I will shorten the unsorted list. Finally, I would repeat the above processes until only one element is left in the unsorted list. Okay, let us see an example. Suppose I have these five numbers being unsorted. Now I would like to see whether some kind of swapping is needed. I would like to find out the smallest element in the unsorted list. For this particular unsorted list, the element with number 1 is the smallest one, okay? And I'm going to swap number 1 with the first element in the unsorted list, which is equal to 3. So I'm going to swap the two numbers. Now, swapping is complete. So we can see that we have a sorted number on the far left-hand side of the whole list, which is element with number 1. And I would have four numbers remaining unsorted. So in this case, the unsorted list will be shorted and the sorted list will be lengthened. Okay, I'm going to find out the smallest element in the unsorted list, which is equal to element with number 2. Okay. We can see that the pink arrow is going to give you the range of the unsorted list. So I simply pick up the smallest number in this range, which is equal to the element with number 2. Now I would like to swap the element with number 2 to the very first element in the unsorted list, which is simply the element with number 3. Now I have done the swapping between the two elements, and in this situation I have one more sorted element, which is simply the element with number 2. So now I put it on the second element in the whole list. So now the sorted list is lengthened while the unsorted list is shortened. Okay, we repeat the comparison process in the unsorted list. So now we find out the smallest number in the unsorted list, which is equal to the element with number 3. I would like to swap the number obtained previously with the smallest element in the unsorted list, which is the element with number 5. Now I've done the swapping. So now the sorted list is lengthened by including element with number 3 at the end of the sorted list. And the unsorted list will be shortened by one element. Okay, I continue the process in the unsorted list. I would like to find the number which is the smallest one in the unsorted list. I got 4 in the unsorted list being the smallest number. So I can see that the smallest element is the first element in the unsorted list. So for this case, I don't need to swap it with any other number in the unsorted list. In case of no swap, I would simply put that element in the sorted list component. So I would pack number 4 to the sorted list part. So in this case, I can again say that the sorted list is lengthened while the unsorted list is shortened. And now only one unsorted element remains. So I can say that the previous numbers are already sorted, and altogether the sorting process is complete by the selection sort algorithm. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comments section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.